The history of the Australian Defence Force Academy began in 1959, when investigations were made into the desirability and feasibility of integrating officer cadet training of the three arms of the Australian Defence Force. In 1970, the plan was crystallised. Then, in 1977, the government agreed to establish the Australian Defence Force Academy on this site, adjacent to the Royal Military College, Dundrum. In May 1981, the University of New South Wales agreed to provide the academic integrity. Then, in 1982, the Interim Academy Council, chaired by Sir Edward Woodward, held its inaugural meeting. In 1984, then Chief of the Defence Force, Air Chief Marshal Sir Neville McNamara, formally established the Australian Defence Force Academy. For our graduates, the years of hard work within the rich fabric of the Australian Defence Force Academy's academic and military education system has finally come to this day. On parade today will be 310 personnel. Of these, 286 are graduating. A large number of these young men and women will be posted to their respective single service establishments around Australia to commence their careers, or to continue their training, whilst Army cadets will proceed to the Royal Military College, Dundrum. For our international students, some will return home having been outstanding ambassadors for their country, whilst others will remain and continue with further studies. Graduates studying four-year degrees will remain at the Academy in 2021. The drill for today's parade has been developed specifically for use within the tri-service environment of the Australian Defence Force Academy. It is based on Royal Australian Air Force foot and static drill, Royal Australian Navy sword drill, and in accordance with Army ceremonial procedures, using Army words of command. Another first for this 2020 parade is a format that has been designed to ensure that the graduating class finish where they started, here on the parade ground, albeit in a fitted, socially distanced format. There is another truly unique aspect we are about to see with this graduation parade, and that is the former midshipmen of the Royal Australian Navy will march onto this parade as sub-lieutenants, and the former officer cadets of the Royal Australian Air Force will march on as private officers. For some of our international trainees who have completed their military and academic studies here at the Academy, they too march onto this sacred ground as pilot officers, sub-lieutenants, acting sub-lieutenants, lieutenants, ensigns and officer cadets. The high standards of drill, dress and bearing is a result of the military training program conducted here at the Academy and has been achieved through the dedication and hard work of the military staff who have trained those on parade and the parade participants themselves. The parade will formally receive the Commandant of the Australian Defence Force Academy, Commodore Peter Levy, accompanied by the Rector of the University of New South Wales, Canberra, Professor Michael Fraser, the Chief of the Defence Force, General Angus Campbell, and the Reviewing Officer, the Governor-General of the Commonwealth of Australia, His Excellency General the Honourable David Burley. The formal arrivals will be followed by the Reviewing Officer's inspection, followed by the advance and review order. Seven individual prizes for a combination of leadership and academic excellence will be awarded this morning. They are the Commander-in-Chief's Medal and the Mr. Robert Crawley Sword, awarded by the Governor-General of Australia, the Chief of Defence Force Sword of Honour for Leadership, the three Chief of Service Prizes, the Returned and Services League of Australia Sword for Service, and during a very special parade of firsts for this 2020 year, the last award to be presented will be the inaugural Commandant's International Training Sword, again kindly permitted by Mr. Robert Crawley of Crawley Swords. The Governor-General will then be invited to address the parade. Shortly, the parade will march onto the main parade ground the strains of Scotland the Brave. For this 2020 graduation parade, there will not be the usual forming up of the graduates by their squadrons. You will notice by the numbers on parade that we do not have the first and second year training officers with us today, with the exception of a few who have volunteered their time to be here to support the Academy Band. The Academy Band, pipes and drums, comprises 47 volunteers from within the cadet body who will present the music for today's parade. The bandmaster, Warrant Officer Class 2 Michael Lee, and the Academy Drum Major, Officer Cadet Casey Chrysler, will lead them onto the parade ground. Sub-Lieutenant Tiffany McCormick, who has held the appointment of the Academy Cadet Captain, the most senior training officer appointment within the Academy, is appointed as parade commander. Sub-Lieutenants, pilot officers, and Army Officer Cadets fill the parade appointments for the parade. Pilot Officer Abdullah Yunus of the Pakistan Air Force, who has been the Academy Executive Officer, is the parade second in command. Officer Cadet Bridget Free, who has been the Academy Chief of Staff, is the parade adjutant. Pilot Officer Xavier Zeke is the Squadron Captain of Alpha Squadron. Sub-Lieutenant Emma Pilling is the Squadron Cadet Captain of Delta Squadron. Officer Cadet Samuel Darwell is the Squadron Cadet Captain of Echo Squadron. Officer Cadet Sarah Flint is the Squadron Cadet Captain of Echoes. The Banner Ensign in the Governor General's Banner Party is Officer Cadet Nathan Massingham. This year, Officer Cadet Massingham held the extremely demanding position of President of the Academy Cadets Mess. The Banner Escorts are Sub-Lieutenant William Anderson and Pilot Officer Wendy Q. The Regimental Sergeant Major of the Australian Defence Force Academy, Warrant Officer Class 1, Andrew Remond, will now march onto the parade ground. The parade ground holds a symbolic representation of a sanctuary of a unit's fallen soldiers. In line with this symbolism, it is deemed hallowed ground and is respected as such. Now marching on in a unique way, performing drill movements not seen before here at ADFA. The parade will be conducting these movements with minimal words of command, demonstrating their excellence on the parade ground and their self-discipline. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Australian Defence Force Academy. The Regimental Sergeant Major will now hand over to the Parade Adjutant, Officer Cadet Bridget Free. The Parade Adjutant will post the parade appointments, then hand over to the Parade Second in Command. The Parade Adjutant will now hand over to the Parade Second in Command, Pilot Officer Abdullah Yunus of the Pakistan Air Force. The Parade Second in Command will now hand over to the Parade Commander, Sub-Lieutenant Tiffany McCormick. The Governor General's banner is now to be marched onto the parade ground. Would all guests please stand? Gentlemen are requested to remove headdress, and military members are to salute only when the banner is in position and the band plays the musical salute, Point of War. There is no requirement for uniformed personnel to salute as the banner passes their immediate front. The salute will be accompanied by a flypast of two of the Royal Australian Air Force's newest capability, the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, the Commandant of the Australian Defence Force Academy, Commodore Peter Levy, and the Rector of the University of New South Wales, Canberra, Professor Michael Frater, will be formally received by the parade. The Commandant is the parade host officer. The principal official guest for this parade is the Chief of the Defence Force, General Angus Campbell, He will now be formally received by the parade. In a few moments' time, the parade will receive the reviewing officer, the Governor-General of the Commonwealth of Australia, His Excellency General the Honourable David Hurley. He will be accorded a royal salute by the parade. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the arrival of the reviewing officer and the royal salute. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the reviewing officer, the Governor General of the Commonwealth of Australia, His Excellency General the Honourable David Hurley. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. The parade commander has invited the reviewing officer to inspect the parade. The commandant of the Australian Defence Force Academy is accompanying the reviewing officer. Following his inspection of the parade, the reviewing officer will inspect the academy band, pipes and drums before returning to the dais. Thank you. The parade will now conduct the advance and review order. The tradition of advance and review order originates from the British infantry and a series of 18 manoeuvres designed to combat both the offensive and defensive tactics of an enemy. Presenting arms to the reviewing officer is attributed to the actions of the Coldstream Guards offering allegiance to King Charles II on his return to the throne by holding up their weapons in a harmless position. The act of inspection by the reviewing officer is also from the same period, where it is believed that on the return of King Charles II to England, soldiers were inspected by the King personally so that he could determine their attitude and sincerity to serve him by looking at their facial expressions. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the advance and review order, followed by the Royal Salute. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The parade will now commence presentation of the 2020 prizes and awards. The Governor General will now present the Commander-in-Chief's coin and the Pooley sword. The Commander-in-Chief's award consists of a medal made of 22 karat gold and a sword that has generously been donated by Mr. Robert Pooley of Pooley Swords, Sheffield, London. This prize is awarded for the most exceptional performance by a third year midshipman or officer cadet in the fields of academic and military achievement, leadership, personal example, and the performance of duty during their time at the Australian Defence Force Academy. The Commander in Chief's Award is awarded to Sub Lieutenant Tiffany McCormick. Sub-Lieutenant McCormick joined the Royal Australian Navy on the 27th of January 2017 from Canberra as an aviation warfare officer. She has served after this year as the Academy Cadet Captain and has further contributed to the Academy and the wider community through taking part in Year 1 Familiarisation Training Mentoring, Operation Bushfire Assist and the Year 1 Character Mentoring Cell Package, as well as volunteering for numerous charity and community service initiatives. She departs ADFA to commence a posting to the Maritime Operations in the Headquarters Joint Operation Command before proceeding to continue in the Royal Australian Navy Aviation Training Continuum. Mr. Pooley has provided us with a message to convey to Sub-Lieutenant.
I am thrilled and honoured and delighted to know that the Pooley Sword of Honour for the Australian Defence Force Academy for 2020 has been awarded to a truly outstanding young officer with a very bright future ahead. Well done, Tiffany. This is very much a deserved honour indeed. And I look forward to following your career in the future.
The Chief of the Defence Force, General Angus Campbell, will now present the Chief of the Defence Force Sword of Honour for Leadership. It is awarded to the third year midshipman or officer cadet for outstanding leadership and consistently excellent performance by a third year midshipman or officer cadet in the fields of officer development, personal example, and application of duty during their time at the Australian Defence Force Academy. This year, the Chief of the Defence Force Sword of Honour for Leadership is awarded to Private Officer Tavis Ellis Southwell. Private Officer Ellis Southwell joined the RAAF on the 29th of January 2018 as a Personnel Capability Officer. In all semesters over the 3 years at ADFA, he has received a Commandant's Commendation for Academics, and in 2020 has held the J8 Academy Cadet Headquarters position, the Community Service Representative for Echo Squadron, and the Student Representative for the School of Business. He has been instrumental in numerous squadron initiatives, including fundraising, mentoring of the first year cohort, and facilitating the year one character mentoring package. Of most significance, he provided a communications link between the Air Force Training School and the single service training cohort while the RAAF liaison position was in transition. The maturity and professionalism demonstrated is commended and displays the potential of his leadership in future endeavours within the ADF and his first appointment at the RAAF base, Edinburgh. The Chief of Service Prizes are awarded to a graduate from each service for the most outstanding performance by a third year trainee officer in the fields of military and academic achievement, leadership, personal example and service ethos during their time at the Australian Defence Force Academy. In addition to meeting the selection criteria, the prize winners are required to be models of the Australian Defence Force values of service, courage, respect, integrity and excellence. Rear Admiral Colin Lawrence, representing the Chief of Navy, will present the Chief of Navy Prize. It is awarded to Sub-Lieutenant Emma Tilling. Sub-Lieutenant Tilling enlisted in the Royal Australian Navy on the 27th of January 2017 from her home location in Melbourne, Victoria, as a Maritime Warfare Officer. Sub-Lieutenant Tilling volunteered as a Year 1 familiarisation training mentor in January 20, and her personal drive, attitude and motivation significantly contributed to the successful outcomes of the Year 1 trainings. Sub-Lieutenant Tilling was Delta Squadron Cadet Captain, demonstrating strong leadership in both academics and military endeavours during a very difficult year, and will post to HMAS Watson to continue her maritime warfare course. The Chief of Army, Lieutenant General Rick Burr, will now present the Chief of Army Prize. It is awarded to Officer Cadet Sarah Flint. Officer Cadet Flint first joined the RAAF as an aeronautical engineer in January 2018 from Sydney, before transferring to the Army as a General Service Officer in January 2019. She has served ADFA this year in the capacity as Squadron Cadet Captain for Foxtrot Squadron. Officer Cadet Flint will complete her engineering honours studies in ADFA in 2021 moving to Omega Squadron, before continuing to the Royal Military College Shantrun in 2022. The Chief of Air Force, Air Marshal Mel Hutfeld, will now present the Chief of Air Force Prize. It is awarded to Pilot Officer Xavier Zegi. Pilot Officer Zegi is from Warrnambool in Victoria. On the 29th of January 2018, he commissioned into the RAAF as an aeronautical engineer on the commencement of his training at ADFA. Pilot Officer Zegi has excelled in both his academic and military studies while at ADFA. In 2020, he was the Alpha Squadron Cadet Captain, during which time he showed incredible leadership during a particularly trying year, actively monitoring and promoting the welfare and morale of the members of the squadron. He led Alpha Squadron with maturity and poise, and was instrumental in leading Alpha Squadron in winning the Lancaster Cup. Pilot Officer Zegi will be remaining at ADFA in 2021, moving to Omega Squadron to complete the fourth year of his engineering degree. Chief of Joint Capabilities, Vice Admiral Jonathan Mead, will now present the Returned and Services League of Australia Sword for Service. The Returned and Services League of Australia Sword for Service is awarded to the third year midshipman or officer cadet who has made the greatest contribution to ADFA by their service, adherence to ADFA values, and living the attributes by personal example. The Returned and Services League of Australia Sword for Service is awarded to Officer Cadet Nathan Massingham. Officer Cadet Massingham joined the Australian Regular Army as a General Service Officer on the 29th of January 2018 from his home location, Butler, in Queensland. He has held the key leadership position of President of the Academy Mess, one of the largest messes in the ADF. Some of the most notable achievements Officer Cadet Massingham has achieved during his time at ADFA are implementing and rollout of the Academy Cadets Mess standard operating procedures, reviewed and assistance in rewriting the Regimental Trust Fund Constitution, and the implementation of the Academy Cadets Mess honorary membership. Officer Cadet Massingham will proceed to the Royal Military College Duntroon on graduation from ADFA to complete his Army officer training. This year, there is a new award to recognise excellence, the Commandant's International Trainee Sword of Honour. This Sword of Honour is an extraordinary broadsword kindly donated by Mr. Robert Burley. This award recognises exceptional performance by a third-year international trainee in the fields of academic and military achievement, leadership, personal example and performance of duty during their time at the Australian Defence Force Academy. The inaugural recipient of this award is Pilot Officer Abdullah Yunus of the Pakistan Air Force.
Sir!
Pilot Officer Yunus joined service on the 17th of October 2016. His home location is Pinchet Colony, Nellore, Islamabad, Pakistan. He is an area engineer who has held the position of Academy Cadet Executive Officer. Pilot Officer Eunice will move to Omega Squadron next year to complete his final year of his engineering degree as an advanced student. His contributions to ADFA are numerous, including the ADFA resilience campaigns, bike donations to charity, and many other programs where his efforts have directly benefited the Academy. Mr. Pooley has provided us with a message to convey to Pilot Officer Abdullah Eunice.
Abdullah, from the brief and memorable time we spent together, I could see your potential shining through. It was very clear to me that you would be extremely successful at the Australian Defence Force Academy and beyond. Congratulations on winning the International Sword of Honour. Your hard work and energy are an example to us all, and a credit to the Academy and the Pakistan Air Force.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the reviewing officer will now address the parade.
Well, good morning all. Congratulations for reaching this point in your education and your training to be graduating from the Academy, and some in services moving on to begin their career as officers, others awaiting Duntroon next year. But for all, an outstanding achievement. Congratulations, and particularly congratulations to those who received awards today. I begin by acknowledging that the Academy here sits on the land of the Ngunnawal people, who have cared for Canberra and the region for generation after generation, and pay respect to their elders past and present. Could I acknowledge the presence of General Angus Campbell, the Chief of the Defence Force, and other senior ADF members, Mr. Melad Rad, the Ambassador of the Lebanese Republic, and members of the Diplomatic Corps, Commodore Peter Levy, the Commandant of ADFA, Professor Michael Frater, the Rector of the University of New South Wales at ADFA, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I began at the RMC graduation on Wednesday by saying that given the constraints at attendance today, Linda and I feel like de facto parents, and indeed the age of some of your grandparents on parade today. So if you'll accept that from us, speaking for your families, congratulations. I know they'd all be loved to be here today to see this very special step, experience in your lives. And through us, we say thank you and well done. Today marks a successful completion of 3 years of military and undergraduate studies. I'm sure you're like I was at college, you thought this day would never come. It's been a particularly difficult year, we know, COVID-19. Saw you having to meet the challenge of your studies moving online, not having the normal occasions to gather. But as we expect from people with initiative, we look around, we accept challenges, you got through this with good humour, ingenuity, your online study groups, speaking sessions online, competitions to maintain morale. And indeed, I must admit, you're far better online students than I was here with my Indonesian class. So for my fellow Indonesian students, my apologies that my online attendance dropped off dramatically during the year. But you persevered. You have now gained your tertiary qualification. I encourage you, when you come across unforeseen challenges in the future, to reflect on what you did this year, not in the physical, but the way you fought through it, to apply that in the future. As graduates, the education and training you have received in ADFA will equip you as you perform your duties in young officers, as young officers in the Australian Defence Force, or in your home military force. I encourage you to further develop the networks you've established here, both within the ADF and with your international colleagues. From personal experience, these connections will enhance both the future interoperability of the ADF and our ability to operate with our international partners. You began your ADF career at a critical juncture. As I've said to each of the graduations this week, the ADF is deeply embedded in the community and has before it an enormous task of protecting our country while reassuring and reaffirming its relationship with the Australian people following the findings of the Brereton Inquiry. Bringing the Australian people along with the ADF will be an enormous part of your work in the future. You arrived here today through your hard efforts, but of course with the efforts of others. Behind your success on this parade ground are the ADFA staff, your families and friends. To the ADFA staff, both the military and academic, those who provide the administrative support and keep the life systems running. Thank you for investing your time and expertise in helping to develop the next generation of young officers we see here today. I'm sure the graduates will reflect on your teachings and your sage advice in the years to come. For the families and friends watching online, of course today's parade is a very proud moment for you. The unconditional encouragement and support you have provided to loved ones is a part of the success on show today. We thank you deeply for it. And finally, to the graduates, including our international students of ADFA's 34th class, again, congratulations. Today marks the completion of phase one of your military career. You are extremely well equipped to make an important contribution to your country. As future commissioned officers, you'll be command of Australians for those from Australia or men and women from your own country. This is one of the proudest things, but the highest responsibility that you can be asked to cover, particularly when you take people into positions or places of peril. Leadership is not easy. I think you've learned that by now. You'll have to make decisions that have consequences for people and often make those decisions under pressure. You need to develop an inner strength to be able to do that. You are either there now or well on that journey. Have confidence in your ability, but most importantly, the lesson I learned, and I've again said this a number of times to junior graduates this year, and the good Lord gave us two ears and one mouth for a reason. Listen. When you arrive in units, particularly those from the Air Force and the Navy, there will be people who have years of experience ahead of you. They will respect you. Listen to them. They are your secrets to success as a leader. So again, my best wishes, congratulations, achieving this important milestone today. Enjoy the moment today. Best wishes for the future, and soldier well. Thank you.
The 2020 Banner Party will now hand over the Governor General's banner to the 2021 Banner Party. This represents an important milestone for the new Banner Party, where they will become the custodians and protectors of the Governor General's banner. Thank you.
Banner escorts at large 10. Banner escorts hold arms. We, the graduating class of 2020, pass this banner to you. It is a symbol of the Australian Defence Force's values of service, courage, respect, integrity and excellence. It embodies the traditions of those who have served before us. Go forth, uphold these values and lead this academy.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for the departure of the reviewing officer and the royal salute.
Parade! Royal salute! Present! Us!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated.
Parade! Stand at ease!
Stand at ease!
The parade will now farewell the Chief of the Defence Force, General Angus Campbell.
Parade! Stand at ease!
Stand at ease!
The parade will now farewell the Commandant of the Australian Defence Force Academy, Commodore Peter Leahy, and the Rector of the University of New South Wales, Canberra, Professor Michael Fraser.
Parade! Stand at ease!
Stand at ease!
Parade! Attention!
Stand at
The Governor General's banner will now be marched from the parade ground. Please stand as the banner is marched off. Gentlemen are requested to remove headdress, and members in uniform are to salute during the playing of point of war. There is no requirement for uniformed personnel to salute as the banner passes their immediate front.
Parade! Present! Arms!
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Parade! Stand at ease!
Parade! Stand at ease!
Parade! Attention!
Parade! Attention!
Third year band!
The 2020 class will now be called
for the final time. Whoa! Help!